Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to look at applying a very small starlight effect to a portrait. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a sort of starlight effect like this in an image, and we're going to do it using a simple brush. Now, you could add it to a shiny point on a portrait, for example, someone's eye, or you could add a much larger one to a background. All I'm going to do is show you where you can find the kind of tools that you would use for this process and how to do it. So let's just close this image down right now, and this is the original image that we're working on. This is actually a very low res image, so I'm just going to start with it here. And before we can get started, we need a brush to use. So I just went to the web and I looked up free star brushes, and I found a set of star brushes here that I kind of liked, and so all I did was click to download them. Once they're downloaded, you'll need to unzip them. So these are nearly ready for us to have a look at. Here they are. They've opened automatically, and this is the file I'm looking for, this ABR file. So I will click to extract all the files because I need to extract the ABR file from the zip file. Having done that, I need to put it in the place where Photoshop can find it. I'll select the file, and I'm actually just going to copy and paste it. So I'm going to copy it, and now the location that we're going to use is on the C drive. So we'll go to C drive and then users. I'm going to my user area here, and then I'll choose app data. From app data in here, I will choose roaming and then Adobe. And now I'll choose my version of Adobe Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop CS6 right now, so I'm going to click CS6. And then I'm going to just open that folder, go to Presets, and then go to Brushes. And I'm just going to paste it here into Brushes. Now, I already have it in here, so I'm just going to replace that set. Now we can come out and we can go to Photoshop and load these brushes. Now, if we were to close Photoshop and reopen it, the brushes would be pretty much accessible to us. So I'm going to do that right now. I'm just going to close this image. We'll save this. And let's close Photoshop and reopen it. Now, when I reopen Photoshop, I'm going back to opening my file, and the brush should now be available. So we're going to click the brush tool here, and then I'll go to the brush palette and select this small icon, the gear icon in the top corner, and now the brush will be in the list here, because Photoshop's had a chance to read that brushes preset folder, and this is the list of all the brushes that are in that folder. So I want to select that one, and I just want to append these. So I want to append them to the end of my brushes set. So I'm going to need to go down to the very end to find them. Now I've got them in twice because I've appended them twice, but that's all right. I'm going to click this one. This is a four-pointed star effect brush. So I'm just going to click it to use it. Now it's way too big for this image, so I'm just going to size it down by pressing the square bracket key. We'll also just zoom into the image so that we can see clearly the area that we're going to be working on. And the brush size is reasonably good, maybe just a little bit smaller. Now I want to work on a new layer because that will separate the glint or the star effect from the rest of the image so that if I need to move it or change it, I can do so. I'm going to make sure white is my foreground color, and I'm just going to click where I want the star effect to be. And if it's too much of an effect, I can just wind down the opacity of the layer. Because the star effect is on a layer by itself, I can click that layer and click the Move tool. And now we could rotate it around, so instead of being up and down, we could have a sort of diagonal star effect. What you may want to do if you've got an image like I have here, where perhaps the eyes are a little bit on the soft side, I selected the Sharpen tool here. I've turned the strength down to 23%. I'm on the layer that has the girl's face on it, and I'm just going to sharpen her eyes just a little bit. And by sharpening the eyes, I'll just brighten them a little bit, and so they're a little bit better to support the glint, the starlight effect that I've put in her eyes. And there's the final result. Of course, it can be moved around by just clicking on the move tool. Click on that layer and we can move it wherever we want to move it to. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more tutorials on this YouTube channel and consider subscribing to the channel for access to more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, and a whole lot more.